Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. I apologize. I'm late. That is so unlike me. Couldn't find my phone. My. Good morning. Praise the Lord. Hope everybody's doing well. Amen. Glad to have all of you on this morning. As you come in, if you would hit like and share, please forgive my tardiness. I could not find the phone that I record on. Could not find it at all. But praise God. Hallelujah. Good morning. Come on in. If you would, hit like and share. Let's join together in prayer this morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Sister Geraldine, good morning. Hope all is well with your grandson. We've been praying and praying for him. Good morning, Sister Michelle. Good morning, Sister Bobby. Praise the name of the Lord. Can you believe today is Thursday, November 5th? Good morning, everybody. Come on in. Please, ma'am and sir, hit like and share so we can share this with others. Amen. Good morning, Mother Ellis. Today is Thursday, November 5th. Thursday, November 5th. Yep. Praise the name of the Lord. Thursday, November 5th. I do apologize. I was late. You all, I could not find the device that I'm recording on. And guess what? It was in my car under the seat. Lord help. Lord help. But I'm here. Amen. Amen. Good morning, Sister Christine. Praise the Lord. You all come in, hit like and hit share. Again, I apologize for being tardy, but we're on. We're joining together in prayer. There is power in prayer. Never underestimate the power of prayer. As long as we're praying according to the manual, which is the word of God, and we are praying in faith. In other words, we believe we receive it before we even get it in manifestation. Why? Because God said it. Good morning, Sister Victoria. Good morning. Wendell, good morning, sir. Glad to have you on this morning. As you all come in, please, ma'am and sir, hit like and share. We're going to go ahead and get started this morning. As you know, the Full Gospel Baptist Church Fellowship, which we are a part of, has designated 7 days of prayer this week. And we are on day number 5. Today is Thursday, November 5th. Started on Sunday. It'll end on Saturday. And today we're praying concerning health and healing. Health and healing. Somebody type in health and healing. Health and healing. As you come in, again, hit like and share. Health and healing. We're going to read a few scriptures. Isaiah 53:5. Isaiah 53:5. Now, when you're praying for yourself, you never have to pray, Lord, heal me if it be your will. Healing is already God's will. It's part of the redemptive work of the cross. Okay, Jesus did not just die for your salvation. He also died for your healing. But as it relates to healing, there's a natural side and then there's a spiritual side. We can't eat whatever we want to eat, not get the proper rest, not drink water, and expect our bodies to be strong and healthy. We have to learn in the area of food and nutrition to be disciplined believers. Many things that we deal with as believers, high blood pressure, diabetes, those things can be self-corrected, can be corrected by our diet. Amen? But healing is God's will. Now, let me say this. Healing is not God's best. God's best is for you to not have to not be sick at all and not need healing at all. That's his best. No condemnation, though. We're not saying you have sinned because you have some kind of sickness or disease that attacked your body. No. But healing is not God's best. God's best is divine health. That means not being sick. And we have a responsibility to take care of our physical temple. We have the responsibility. That's our responsibility. The Bible says bodily exercise profiteth little. Okay? We don't want to cut our time short on earth because we're not doing what's necessary with our physical temple. The Bible says, know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost, which you have of God, which ye have of him. And we are not our own. We are bought with a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are his. Isaiah 53 and 5, it says this: surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. Yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. I'm going to read that to you out of the Amplified. Isaiah 53, somebody type that in if you can. Isaiah 53 verses 4 and 5, I'm reading out of the Amplified. It says, surely he has borne our griefs, sicknesses, weaknesses, and distresses, and carried our sorrows and pains of punishment. Yet we ignorantly considered him stricken, smitten, and afflicted by God as if it was leprosy. But verse 5 says this: but he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our guilt and iniquities. The chastisement needful to obtain peace and well-being for us was upon him. And with his stripes that wounded him, we are healed and made whole. Go to Matthew chapter 8. Matthew chapter 8. Matthew 8 and 17. Healing is God's will. Somebody type that in. Healing is God's will. So when you pray for healing, you have to pray, Lord, heal me if it be your will. His will is healing. God's word is his will. It says that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by Isaiah the prophet, saying, okay, this is the fulfillment of what Isaiah prophesied. Himself took our infirmities, talking about Jesus, and bare our sicknesses. That's clear as day. Jesus, the Christ, he took our infirmities and he bare our sicknesses. Let me read it to you out of the Amplified. And thus he fulfilled what was spoken by the prophet Isaiah. He himself took in order to carry away our weaknesses and infirmities and bore away our diseases. So if Jesus bore our diseases and our sicknesses, then we shouldn't have to bear them. But again, we have to be custodians over our temple. We have to maintain. We got to be careful what we put in this temple. We got to be careful how we treat this temple, okay? We have a responsibility. God has already done his part. We got to do our part. In the near future, I'm going to do a series on SOS, help my flesh needs discipline. Because in order to lose weight, in order to get your body in order, you have to be disciplined. And in the body of Christ, sometimes that's a bad word. Amen? Praise God. But amen, we need to be disciplined. Discipline, discipline. Reverse the curse. Reverse those generational curses. You don't have to have high blood pressure and diabetes because it runs in your family. And really, what I found out years ago at a health seminar is not in your DNA necessarily. It's the habits that's passed along that, you know, we pick up habits. We cook, most of us cook how our family cook, you know, our family of origin. And so we pass along bad habits. But we can change that in Jesus' name. God, the super plus the natural equals supernatural. And God's super will get on your natural. He will give you the ability to do what you don't feel like you can do in and of yourself. Amen? All right, enough about that. I can preach about health and healing all day. But let's go ahead and believe God, okay? Pastor, why do I need to be healthy and strong so that you can be used in this last day harvest? So God can get the maximum out of you so you can touch other people's lives. If you are spending all of your time visiting the doctor and going here and going there and taking medication and experiencing the results of that medication because you don't feel like it, what it does, it impedes what God can do in your life. Now, let me say this too. Because I've been in church all my life and I've seen people get on the wrong side of this. You know, some people say, if you really got faith, you won't take medicine. Hear me, beloved. Take your medication. But you pray over your medication like you pray over your food. You release your faith over your medication. I thank you, Father, that this medication is doing what it was designed to do. And I declare that I will not receive any of the side effects. Okay? Take your medication, believe God, but just if you take your medicine three times a day, then you take this medicine three times a day. You get it, you speak the word of God concerning your healing. Get it, find scriptures in the Bible that concern your healing, okay? And just because someone transitioned in your family from a particular thing don't mean you have to transition. All right, again, I told you I could talk about it all day. Let's pray. Come on, lift up your hands. That's just a prayer posture. Nothing spooky about it. It's just an act of surrender. Now, if you're driving, Sister Michelle, don't lift your hands up. Please, ma'am. Please, sir. Don't do that. Lift up your hands. Let's pray. Father, in Jesus' name, we come before you this morning. Father, we are so grateful and thankful for this opportunity to pray. We give you glory, honor, and praise. We magnify your great and awesome name, how great you are, how awesome you are, how mighty you are. We are so thankful this morning. We are thankful for life, health, and strength, Father. Thank you for our rest on last night. Thank you for our rising this morning. Thank you, Father God, that we are in our right mind. Thank you that we have the activity of our limbs. Thank you that we have a mouth that we can talk, eyes that we can see, ears that we can hear. Thank you, Father God, that our heart beats with the rhythm of life. Thank you that the very blood of Jesus is flowing through our veins, flushing out any impurity. Thank you for 1 Peter 2:22, 23, and 24 that's working in our body right now. Thank you, Father God, that long life is our portion, Father. You said with long life will you satisfy us and show us your salvation. We give you praise, Father. We thank you, Father, for the promise of longevity. But not longevity just to have longevity, but to fulfill your plan and your purpose for our lives. Father, no matter how old we are, Father, we know you have a plan and a purpose for our life. And Father, I'm believing you. And we agree together that if we don't know what that is, that no matter how old we are, you will reveal it to us right now in Jesus' name. That we will know why we are here. And we will begin to live out your purpose and plan for our life each and every day, Father God. I thank you for the people that you've called us to reach individually, Father. There are people that only we can reach individually. So, Father, I thank you that we would get into your plan, get into your purpose, and Father, we will walk it out in Jesus' name. And so, Father, we thank you for healing over the body of Christ. We thank you for health and healing, Father. Father, we pray in Jesus' name that we will not continue to turn a deaf ear to health and wellness, Lord God, that we would realize that it is a part of our package and that we have a responsibility to take care of the temple of the living God. Father, help us with our eating. Oh God, we admit that for many of us, we have gone over into lasciviousness. In other words, we have lost restraints with our eating. Help us, God. Somebody type in help. Help us, God, with our eating. Help us to eat better. Help us to learn what to eat and how to eat. And even help us to unlearn bad habits of eating. Father, I bind addiction to sugar this morning. Oh, in the name of Jesus, help us, Father, in that area. Addiction to sugar, Father, in the name of Jesus. And Lord, many of us, we eat for comfort. Father, help us to get to the crux of the matter. The reason why we're eating, Father, we do a lot of emotional eating, but we speak to our emotions. We know you want us to be whole, body, soul, and spirit. So we speak to our emotions. We speak to our mind, our will, Father. We declare that we are emotionally sound in Jesus' name. Father, we give you praise. Father, we give you glory. We magnify your name. We're doing the things we need to do. We're getting the proper rest, Father. We're not being weighed down with stress and worry. And Father, I even come against stress right now. Hallelujah, Father. I even come against unforgiveness right now. Hallelujah, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, Father, we thank you, Father. We thank you that we're releasing the stress. We're releasing the worry, the anxiety concerning the coronavirus, concerning this election, Father God, concerning our children, concerning our spouse. We roll in every care on you. And Lord, teach us how to live carefree lives, Lord God, so that we may bring you glory. We bind worry, Lord God. We bind it in Jesus' name. And we lose peace. We lose soundness of mind. Hallelujah, Lord God. For you've not given us a spirit of fear, but power, love, and a sound mind. And so we declare that we have a sound mind. We walk with a sound mind. We come against Alzheimer's. We come against dementia. We have the mind of Christ. Hallelujah, Lord God. And we thank you, Father, that our natural forces will not be abated. We thank you, Father, we're getting better with time. We thank you, though our outward man perish, our inward man is renewed day by day. And we give you praise, Lord God. Thank you, Father God. Hallelujah, Lord God. Thank you for renewing our strength, God. Thank you for giving us strength, God. Renewing our strength. Restoration of strength and power and peace, Father God. We thank you that we overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. And we declare that by the stripes of Jesus, we are healed and made whole. Every organ, every tissue, every muscle of our body functions in the perfection to which you created to function. And we will not permit any malfunction in our bodies in Jesus' name. Body, we command you to line up with the word of God in Jesus' name. And Lord, we give you praise and glory. We thank you, Father, for healing. We thank you for divine health, God. We thank you for reversing the family curse, God. Hallelujah, Lord God. We give you praise. We give you glory, God. And Lord, I pray that the shackles will fall off our mind as it relates to eating, as it relates to taking care of our temple. Open our eyes, Father. Give us more revelation and more understanding of how to take care of our physical body. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. All right, good people, that's it. God is good. God is good. No matter what it looks like, no matter how you feel, God is good. And you got to say it, David. I would have fainted if I wouldn't expect to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Something good is going to happen to you today. You got to set your faith. That's not just a slogan. That's not just something cute we're saying. No, we're establishing our faith. We're expecting good all today. Something good. It's going to happen to you today. You ought to type that in. Something good going to happen to me today. Something good going to happen to you today. Something good going to happen to your family today. Something good going to happen to your children. Stop expecting the negative all the time. Some of us, we have allowed the world and the world's way of thinking to get on the inside of us. We just think negative. We talk negative. We act negative. Everything negative, 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 negative. We are negative Nancy. Negative Nancy and negative Ned. Negative Nancy and negative Ned and doubtful Don. Come on out of there in Jesus' name. Get on the positive side of life. Yes, do bad things happen? Yeah, they happen. But guess what? You don't have to dwell on that. You can dwell on the promise. And God is for you. He's with you. He's in you. You are a world dominator. You didn't come to take sides. You came to take over. Listen, have a blessed day. Again, I apologize about my tardiness this morning. If this was a blessing to you, share it with someone else. Got to get out of here and get my kids to school and go exercise this body. I don't always feel like it, but I speak to my body and I tell my body what to do. Listen, I love you so much. Have a good day. Go and be a blessing to somebody today. You are the answer to somebody's prayer. Love you so much. I'll see you tomorrow. Be blessed.